play actually helps promote survival because it allows animals to have a safe context in which to practice behaviors and skills like hunting or fighting or things like that. Play in social animals like dogs helps promote the formation of social bonds and the maintenance of relationships, which can be important for survival too. And then finally, from the dog's perspective, play is a great way to relieve stress, get out excess energy, as well as gives them an environment in which to experience positive emotions and reward, which are all very important for their welfare. My name is Sophie Barton, and I'm a PhD candidate in the Hecht Lab in the Department of Human Evolutionary Biology, and I study how dogs' brains and behaviors evolve. During lockdown, I was bored just like everyone else, and I spent a lot more time with my dog. One of the things that I started noticing about my dog was all of the different behaviors that she shows during play and how they're different somewhat from the behaviors that I'd seen in other dogs. And it really cued me into this idea that dog play behavior is actually quite diverse. So I thought that this would be a really good study to do to help us improve our knowledge of how dogs play, and in this study in particular, how dogs play with toys. The study took place online because it was during the pandemic. Participants were instructed to film a video of their dog either playing with a familiar toy for 3 minutes, as well as an experimental toy that we told them how to make. And people filmed those videos, and importantly, they were instructed not to interact with their dog during that time, just allow the dog to play. Our preliminary results show that both genetic, environmental, and developmental factors all play a role in how dogs play with toys. For example, we found that dogs that are from breeds that were historically bred for more independent work, like dachshunds, engaged or tried to engage less often with their humans during play, whereas dogs that were bred for collaborative work historically, like border collies, were significantly more likely to try to engage their human with play, such as looking at them, bringing the toy to them, trying to interact in some way. It also was the case that environment plays a role in how they play. In particular, we found that training experience actually influenced how dogs play. So dogs who have had structured training in the sense of doing a sport like agility or nose work or something like that were significantly more likely to try to engage with their human during play than dogs who didn't have that training. And then finally, we found that dogs who were younger or juvenile dogs were significantly more likely to exhibit diverse play behaviors that we didn't see in older dogs. So for instance, younger dogs would play with toys on their back, they would toss the toy and do all sorts of diverse behaviors. So development also plays a role in how dogs play. Dogs are kind of unique in that they continue to play frequently into adulthood, which is something that we don't see very often in the animal kingdom. Some people have proposed this is because dogs are domesticated and we might have selected for more playfulness. Other people have proposed that dogs might play frequently as adults because we just facilitate environments that encourage that behavior. But regardless of that, it's certainly the case that dogs are kind of unique in that they play into adulthood, somewhat like our own species does. I think the study is important because it gives us a crucial window into the cognitive, behavioral, and social aspects of why dogs play and how they play. Play is a really common behavior that dogs exhibit that we know is important for their welfare and we know has evolutionary significance, but we don't know much about it yet. So I think that this study is a really good first step in starting to uncover this really important aspect of the dog behavioral repertoire. With this work in the future, I would like to expand this not only to studying dogs' play behavior, but also potentially the play behavior of other dog relatives, so other canid species. I'm looking to see how that compares to wild species. I'd also be really interested in comparing it to other domesticated animals that we have, like cats, and seeing what the diversity of play looks like in other species as well.